Hello and welcome to this overview of the new print template editor. In this overview, you'll be shown how to navigate around the template editor, use our default templates, and use the main functions to create your own templates. Okay, let's get started. To access the new template editor, go to Tools, Print Template Editor, V3. Okay, here we are. First, if you'd like to find support articles about the new print template editor, go to the Help button. This will give you a list of support articles to help you with more advanced features. Before we start, I must add, you will not be able to import old templates into this template editor. But to get you started, we have built some default templates for you. On the left-hand side, you will see many templates, ranging from blank to different templates we have created. I'm going to select one of the default job templates that also include images sent from engineers. You can search by category or type the name of a template. As you can see, the logo has applied, as I have made the logo default in Settings, Print Settings in Click Service. For more information on this, we have an article on how to do this on our support site. As you can see in this template, we have tags that will display an image and give a description based on the engineer's photo description. If you still don't have a logo, you can simply use the Images button by just dragging and dropping to your desired location. When you have done that, you'll be asked for the type of image, and in this case, I'm just going to use Image. Next, I'm going to add a text box under the owner telephone number and add the owner email. I'm going to drag from the text button to the position I require. You can then select either a text or formatted text. The difference between the two text is with no formatting option is in the template editor. The formatted text allows you to manipulate the look of the text. For example, colored text within the template editor. This will display your company's email address. Now I'm going to add an extra page and show you how to add an action list. Click on the Add Page button, then select the page that has been created. I will drag and drop from the text button and select formatted text and label it action list. But I want a bigger size and to make it bold. So I'll edit the text from here and make it bold. But now to change the size, I can go to the properties of the text box on the right hand side and change the font size. Now I want to put my action list in the template. Simply select the action list button and drag to where you want the action list to populate. That's it. You now have your action list. You can now go to the properties of the action list and make changes to the style of the action list. Now I'm going to check this template by printing it directly from the editor. Simply click print, select a job, and you will get a preview of what it looks like. You can then save it by clicking the disk icon here, giving the template a name and clicking save. You will then be able to use the template when you next print or email a template. Okay, let's do a few things on a different type of template. Let's try a quote template with product images. But this time, select the template from a template I've already created. To do this, go to the top left-hand side and click on the folder icon. This is where all the templates you have saved will be stored. Here, this quote template has some tables already built in, but I can control what the templates display by using the table controls. Let's delete the column price each. If you need to add a column, click the plus sign on the table. You can then go to the properties of the table and select or create a style. For more information on creating styles and tables, please go to our support site. Now let's edit the footer on the quote and add some images and add some text for your bank details. Now let's add some terms and conditions on another page. Simply add another page, select the text box and enlarge the text box to input some T's and C's. If you now want to use shapes to box those T's and C's, just select the box and enlarge it around the text. The other option is called Flow. This allows the text and tables to carry on to more pages. So if you expect to have jobs, quotes, invoices that may go onto multiple pages, you will add text tables into a flow container. More information on flow containers can be found on our support site. That's it. But if you require more information on the new template editor, then please go to our support site, which can be found at www.clicksoftware.com. If you require training on the template editor, then contact your account manager on 0117 902 2012. Thanks for listening.